السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. العباس عليه السلام was the first child of Umm al-Banin. With his birth, Medina shone and the whole world glittered. He was born on the 4th of Sha'ban in the 26th year after Hijrah. Waves of pleasures flowed in the family of Imam Ali عليه السلام for the birth of their magnificent moon that would enlighten this world with his merits and would add immortal glory to the numerous glories of the Hashimites and the Ahlul Bayt alayhum salam. As soon as Imam Ali alayhi salam was given the good news of the birth of this blessed child, he hurried to take him, kiss him frequently, and hold the Sharia ceremonies of newborns. The Imam alayhi salam recited the Adhan in his newborn's right ear and recited the Iqama in the left. Hence, the first voice that penetrated this great newborn's hearing was his father saying, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Allah is the greatest, there is no God but Allah. These great words, which are the message of all prophets, alayhum salam, and the melody of the God-fearing, found a ground in the inner self of Al-Abbas alayhi salam. These words later on became the most significant element of his personality, no doubt. In his future, he would adopt the calling to the true application of these words, for which he would lose all of his limbs. On the seventh day after his birth, Imam Ali alayhi salam shaved Al-Abbas alayhi salam's hair and gave golden and silver arms as weighty as the hair he had cut, as he had done for Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam and Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Imam Ali alayhi salam slaughtered a ram as an offering to God on behalf of this baby. These practices are adopted from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, whose words, practices and confirmations are regarded as authoritative. When it came to naming Abbas alayhi salam, narrations tell us that Zainab alayhi salam turned her face towards her father and asked, Father, have you chosen a name and a nickname for this new baby? Her father answered, Yes, daughter, I have. What are they, father? Zainab alayhi salam asked. The father, as he perceived that this baby would be one of the heroes of Islam and would be frowning in the faces of evils and the wrongdoers, replied, I name him Al-Abbas, the frowning, and nickname him Abul Fadl, father of virtue. Al-Abbas alayhi salam was nursed at the hands of a faithful mother who nurtured him on faith, loyalty, knowledge, devoutness, and high principles. His father too was that great personality who is described as a copy of the Prophet himself, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the inheritor of the Prophet's ilm, his knowledge, and the hero of all combats. Al-Abbas alayhi salam was brought up under the custody of these parents. No wonder then that he possessed such a personality, such traits, and offered such big sacrifices for the sake of his religion, his imams, and principles. Al-Abbas adhered to his father when he was in Medina and when he moved to Iraq and resided in Kufa. Al-Abbas alayhi salam was also under his thoughtful care and wise education and environments. Al-Abbas alayhi salam acquired all virtues, high moral standards, knowledge and conversance after his father's demise. Al-Abbas alayhi salam adhered closely to his two brothers, Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam and Imam al-Husayn. He returned with them to Medina and learned from them the religious knowledge and fundamentals in addition to the nobilities of character. When Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam was poisoned to death, Al-Abbas alayhi salam adhered to his brother Imam al-Husayn and his nephew Imam Ali Zainul Abidin alayhi salam. He kept himself with his brother in Medina, Mecca and Iraq, always remained loyal, where he protected him as well as his haram until he lost his life for his sake. Thus, unlike the other sons of Imam Ali alayhi salam, Al-Abbas alayhi salam had the characteristic of full adherence to his father, two brothers and nephew. For that reason, he was a true copy of the Imams in knowledge and morality. He was their guardian until the very end. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.